Hello everybody. In this video, we're going to have a look at the British Army knife that you've seen me mention before in a customer service rant. It's, well, basic, shall we say? I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so here we have the Sheffield made British Army knife. This is the three blade version. There is a version without the marlin spike. Stainless steel construction, all riveted. It's a big knife. If we just compare it with the Victorinox Spartan copy, it's only slightly longer, but as you can see, it's a lot deeper. Slightly slimmer though. Opening the knife, we've got a thumb nail nick there. You can see the blade isn't really any bigger. But it's mainly, I think, due to the weight that it does feel like quite a big knife. The actual size, from the handle to the tip, we're looking at about 65 millimetres, 2 5/8, I would say. And the overall length when it's closed, it's about 4 inches if you don't include the loop. Yeah, 4 inches. So since it feels like a heavy knife, let's see if we can put some numbers on that. Can you see those figures? Yeah, you can see those. So in grams, it's 112.4, which in English is almost 4.7 ounces. And if you bear in mind the Spartan copy, it's only 2.7 ounces, so it does feel like a big chunky lump of steel. On the back there you've got the marlin spike, which I believe is for untangling knotted rope and such. Probably be quite good if you needed to do some digging as well. And we've seen the main blade with the sheep's foot profile. We've also got a can opener. Quite a big can opener, very thick. There is the suggestion of a bevel on there, but it's completely blunt really. And the point's not sharp. So what I think I'll do is I shall drop in a little bit of footage testing that can opener. Right, so tin of beans, upside down because that's a ring pull, we don't want that, we want the old fashioned side. Now, here we go. Will it work? Yeah, just about. It's not very good. Be an old flaming day, I think. Oh. Well, you get the idea. And to be honest, I wasn't expecting much, even though it's a big, hefty opener. There's no useful cutting edge on it. Oh, I'm going to stop there. Let's get back to the main bit of the video. Right, so the only thing that remains is to try the main blade out. So I've got a piece of paper, which I could have had that ready, I suppose, but there you go. So, here we go. Well, the only way to describe that, I'm afraid, is blunt as fuck. Useless. Absolutely useless. So, we have to do something about that, I think. If you just bear with me for a few moments. There we go. Oh, there we go. So it seems it will take an edge. But it certainly doesn't come with one. And if I'm honest, I haven't got rid completely of all the wibbly wobbliness on the factory edge. It does need more work. At least I've satisfied myself that it will be possible to cut things with it, which I wasn't entirely convinced of at the beginning. So that is the British Army knife, made in Sheffield. It's butt ugly. It weighs a ton. It doesn't come with an edge. I still like it though. Thanks for watching.